So Hermie and I called an Uber to get to the airport, and look who showed up. I'm wondering how retirement's working for you, Steve. Full-time Ubering and a part-time Hermie whisperer. How's that going for you?
So far, so good.
All right. Hey, thanks for the ride.
Hey, anytime.
Hermie, that boarding was painful and very expensive. What do you think about Frontier at this point? Watch yourself after you buy a cheap ticket. Carry-on shoes are free. And carry-on hats are free too. Hermie, you're on your way. The back of Hermie's head. Hermie head view. See ya. Thanks.
Bye.
No filming. Hermie, how's it going?
No filming.
Well, I'm just pretty happy to be in the state of Denver. It's the Buckeye State, right? So Hermie, I noticed you're looking around our hotel and you're kind of limited. Is that all McDonald's?
It is.
What's going on there?
They are the best.
Hey Hermie, we're in Phoenix.
The state of Phoenix? Oh, I love the Granite State.
Big Fish Bill, reporting live with DFUK Sports, Recreation, Outdoor, Sexual Health, and RV Life. Day one in the bag. We flew from Milwaukee, Wisconsin to Phoenix, Arizona last night. Me and my life partner, Hermie Boy. So we're into day two, and this morning we pick up the new Knob One, the Anders RV.
Well, before we get started on our day two update, just want to give a weather update for my friends up in the Northwest. Bob and Tom, you know who you are. It is 38 degrees with a high of 64 degrees. It's very comfortable right now. Had a layover in Denver where we learned some really interesting things. Some green carpet. Learned that it doesn't always mean that it's a driving range.
This here, driving range. And I think Kosh with a 9-iron could hit the mountains.
It actually could be a pet relief area. I'm gonna just warn you that as we go, and Bill keeps dragging my ass out of bed at 4:30 in the morning, I might not be quite so chipper. We're gonna have a great day and pick up an RV today.
Hey, Bill.
Yes.
You are 30 minutes away from getting your first RV. What do you think?
I'm pretty geeked. I've been geeking on this for 10 years and researching in the Big Fish Bill Laboratories for 3 years.
So you're ready?
I am ready.
Let's go.
Dave actually picked us up in our RV.
That's an RV.
How do you feel about that swing, Herm?
Not so good.
Herm, that one would have gone at least 40 yards.
I've heard it said that you are a powerful.
I am super powerful.
Hey, Bill, look, a train.
No freaking way.
Can you imagine that? And they blow their horns. That's unusual.
Yeah,
Yesterday you told me that freight train hardly ever comes through here at 5 a.m. in the morning.
I know. She's supposed to come through at 10 after 4.
Things I've learned about RVing already. It really does get cold in the desert. Taking a warm shower means turning the water heater on with enough time to heat the water. You could fill an RV with food, but Hermie will still stop at Quick Trip and get egg rolls and go to Wendy's for dinner. You could have a self-contained toilet, but Hermie, he looks for other restrooms, thus stops. And I love RVing already. Boom!
Morning.
Take two!
Well, good morning. This is day 3 of the Knob One Extravaganza. Everything's going really well. Bill is an excellent driver.
Of course, I'm an excellent driver.
You know how to drive?
Yeah.
Training with FedEx is really paying off.
Okay! I'm a limo driver!
The only problem that I'm having is that periodically he pulls over to the side and he wants to run up to a house and deliver a package. So we actually have less groceries than what we started with because he keeps trying to deliver it. But I had to put a stop when he tried to deliver my laptop to a house. So we've gotten past that. I think he understands the difference between FedEx and Knob One. So things are going well. Just a weather update. It is 29 degrees here in beautiful Arizona. So it's been an adventure so far. Looking forward to day 3. Hey Billy, I've been doing work on the laptop, so I've kind of lost track. Where are we right now?
Well, we just came back in the United States. We went through New Mexico.
Oh.
I invented tofu.
The ship's haunted.
Dork. Look at all the milfs. Tonight I'm partying. I have 4 stork eggs and a pony. I gotta scoot a bit because of my scrotum. I'm buying a cow.
Don't worry about it. Ding the bell.
A girl injured my heart.
I should have stopped it right there. I always do this. It was getting there, right? I mean, you're about to be a problem. And I hope you zip it. There was a hair in my coffee.
I got a papaya in my jacket, okay? My Slurpee.
I don't like your hot sauce, said the lady.
Just one.
Both U.S. citizens?
Yep.
Have a great day.
All right, thanks.
I thought I'd do a preemptive Marco Polo for Bill. Hey, Hermie, who are we missing? Nobody?
More like, hey, Hermie. Hermie? Oh, crap, I left him at the truck stop.
He can always find Hermie at the truck stop because he's always standing in front of that coupon little thingy, Bob, where they have all those little booklets full of coupons. He'll be there forever. It's like going to Disney World for him.
Okay, guys. Bill just shared the coupon gags. What the hell is that all about? I mean, really, you think...
Ooh. Ooh. Oh, thanks, Bill. That's
You're
awesome.
Welcome.
Hey, Aaron, you gonna dive in?
I was thinking, I'm ready. What? The ice melted this morning.
Oh, and it's not exactly clean. Hey, Hermie, get in here. Hey, who are we missing?
Nobody!
Hey, Hermie, I'm just wondering how the 3:30 a.m. wake-up call is working for you.
It's wonderful. I just feel so refreshed and new.
How about the 11 o'clock urinary call and the 1 o'clock urinary call?
Oh, God.
Don't you just feel rested?
I feel so rested. Day 3, it is...
Hermie, am I interrupting anything?
No, not at all. Bastard. Day 3, it's 54 degrees. I have no idea if it's partly cloudy or... It certainly isn't sunny because it's 4:15 a.m. I did want to pass on some wisdom is... Don't try to go to the bathroom while you're in a moving RV, especially when the driver knows you're trying to take a crap. It just doesn't work well.
Welcome to day 3. Things I learned on day 3 of RV life. Working remote isn't so hard on the person working remote. It's the person that can't talk to anybody, can't listen to music. It's horrible. Calling your buddy your life partner in Texas isn't so cool. Flying your drone in a really old people RV park draws attention. Hey, what is that? Are those bees? Time to hit the road. And how do you know you're in pitch black? When you do this. How was your experience putting an awning up in the pouring down rain thunderstorm?
I don't think the heavy stuff's come down, you know, for quite a while.
Hello, boys. Living a life, reverse angle. And there's Hermie Boy.
That's right. Living it large.
Larger than life. And here I thought a dude shower was something completely different. I'm not disappointed. Another edition of Road Tripping with Hermie! How's it going, Hermie?
I'll tell you, Billy, this is mind-boggling.
Mind-boggling?
Yeah, mind-boggling.
So, Hermie boy, it's the last 40 minutes of the voyage. We're almost home to Green Bay. The question being, would you do it all over again? Oh, hell no! We take separate vacations!
Yeah,
because I'm not going to be on the same continent as you!
I'd buy my own and just drive in front of you and have
you
follow me.
Your own RV, but we stay at separate trailer parks.
Damn right.
Alright.
Oh, my
gosh.
Oh, my gosh! This is nice! Wow.
Look at
curtains and everything.
Yep, curtains and everything.
Oh, hi.
You like?
I do.
And then the bedroom's back there and the bathroom's back there.
Oh, that's a good size.
Yep.
You like?
I do.